I'm not entirely satisfied because there's more things that I can do. Let's go back here to Mighty Roar, and instead of having this cat, we're going to use the same cat. Remember how I made a black and white one and a color one? We're going to use that. We're going to go here to Images, and we're going to click the little arrow, and we're going to do Rollover Image. So this will be, we're just going to call it Mighty Roar for the name. The names aren't really important unless you start having multiple rollover images, then it helps prevent confusion. We're going to have our original image as Mighty Roar BW, and our rollover image as regular Mighty Roar. We're going to go ahead and press OK. And once again, we want this to be aligned right. I'm going to go ahead and save this. And now, if I go to the index file, look at that. So pretty cool. There's even more that we can do with images too. That's not all. Let's say that in my index file, I created like several links all together. So we're going to go ahead and just create a new file, just for example. We're going to call this Enter My Web Page. We're going to shrink it down so you can actually see the whole thing. And then we're going to make a couple more. So, BW. And color. Hide the backgrounds. Crop this to be a little bit more efficient. I'm going to go ahead and do save for web. Now, this isn't that efficient because I have all this extra dead space inside of my image, and I could just break them up into individual images, but I'm just doing this just to show you. So let's go ahead and delete this and instead enter a new image. And we're going to go ahead and put this as front. Now, what we can do is we can make an image map. And instead of having the whole thing go to one spot, what if we want this to go to Mighty Roar, and we want this to go to the black and white image, and this to go to the color image? We can do that. We could break this up into three different images, but we can also use image maps. So let's go ahead and give this a name. So we'll call it front image, and oh, it doesn't like the hyphen. There we go. We're going to use the square, and we're going to highlight all of this text with it. So this is going to go to Mighty Roar. Now, we're not done yet. We're also going to make another one. And this is going to go to mightyroarbw.jpg. And we're going to create another one. And this is going to go to mightyroar.jpg. Now, if you've been paying attention, you've noticed that I've clicked through, I've skipped a few things. When I'm dropping images in, it's been asking me to put an alt code, give it a name, and I really should be. It's really a bad idea not to. The alt code helps people who Maybe they have vision issues, they can't see well. If they're using a screen reader or a web reader or some sort of reader on their computer, if the computer doesn't know what the image is of, it's just going to say image. But if you give it an alt name, that's what it will show. That's what it will say for them. So that way they know what the picture is supposed to be of instead of just saying image file. So we should put alt names too. And we can actually put spaces in the alt names because it's just a string of characters. So we'll call it inner graphic. This will be click to enter. This could be click for BW pick. Click for color pick. And we should do that also on the Mighty Roar picture too. Pick of amazing cat. There we go. So we'll go ahead and save this. We'll go ahead and save that. And let's see what happened. So we've got our index file. If I click this, it goes to Mighty Roar. If I go back and if I click BW, it goes to the black and white image. And if I click color, it goes to the color image. So there you go. There's playing with images. Now, just like the web pages, if you move something, it won't be able to find it. So if I move the Mighty Roar Color Cat, let's go ahead and open index.html and let's see what happens. Right now it's working, but if I mouse over it, it doesn't work. But we do get our alt code, so at least we know what should be there. So just like pages, if you move it, it can't find it. It's linking to that image. That image is not embedded inside of the website. That image is being referenced by the web page and saying, hey, there's an image over here of an amazing cat. You should load it. So that's sort of how that works. So you got to make sure that wherever you have your cat or your image, I guess it doesn't have to be a cat, it needs to stay there if you expect it to work. Otherwise, you need to change the code. If you move the cat and you're convinced you're going to move the cat or whatever your image is of, make sure that you change the code so it reflects that. Otherwise, you're going to have a broken image. Thanks for watching. I hope you found the video useful. If you did, you can very quickly and easily let me know by just clicking the thumbs up or the like button. If you need any help, let me know and I will see what I can do.